So hello class, today we are going to understand a concept of graph. So basically this graph is in broader sense it has got lot of meanings, but one simple thing that we are going to switch around is that what basically the graph is. So dear students, I have just made a web chart which will give you all the details. The first thing, what is the definition of a graph? Graph is just a simple diagrammatic representation, and it will show the interrelationship between the two quantities. So these two quantities can be anything, right? Why we are representing it visually? We are representing it visually just to make and see the facts more easily. As you can see, I have highlighted this point, easy to find the facts, easy to relate those facts, and very importantly, easy to see those facts. Now, where basically we are watching these graphs? Are they really helpful? Yes, when you are watching a cricket match, then you see the scorecards between the I'm just repeating again the two quantities. So two teams, their comparison is there, their scorecards are being compared. Then you have seen recently when we were facing a very difficult time, the corona cases, we always wish to have a lower graph. Then the level of pollution, we always want it less. The amount of rainfall, when we compare it with the previous years and this year, then also we represent it with the rain with the graph. And very importantly, when it's a voting time, election time, then how the different parties have scored and what is the what are the performances there? It can be also visualized through these graphs. So, lot of places are there where we can just I have highlighted few example. Now, basically, this is not that important. What a definition is, how they are helpful, we all know that. But the point in class 7th is how to plot a graph, right? So, what we have to understand first of all that there are three types of basically the graphs we are going to talk about in science. The line graph, our focus will be this part, the bar graphs, you have drawn it in your maths classes, and the pie graph, like as in case of the composition of air, when we are asking the students to draw and show it through a pie chart, then they mention it, nitrogen, this percent, oxygen, and this is how the circular portion is there, and that is a pie graph. Now, when we are plotting a graph, dear students, I have taken out certain points. There are basically the four things that you have to plot in a graph. Point number one, the very first point is the two perpendicular lines. And we call these lines as axis, right? And these two lines are basically the horizontal one, the x-axis, and the y-axis. Now I have shown it through this particular paper graph. Now this is somewhat looking like this is a graph paper, right? It is easily available in the market. And you might have seen this particular page in your backside of the practical notebooks also. Now, you can see a lot of lines here, some darkened lines and some fainted lines, right? So this darker lines, when you are going to see, this is my two axis. Now people can draw it like this also, take a whole page and draw it in the center. But what we are going to do is we are going to save paper. So I'll go to one side, and this is the corner I have taken, and in this corner we are going to draw two perpendicular lines, and these lines are x-axis and y-axis. They are meeting at a point called O. So first thing, you have to draw two lines, right? And just for your information, when you will see and check out with your ruler, you will find that this particular point, this darker line and this darker line, the space between this darker line is 1 centimeter. This is a 1 centimeter square box. Now, this is the first point that you must understand. Two perpendicular lines. What are the two lines? X-axis, y-axis. X-axis is horizontal and vertical is a building above it, right? Now, second thing, in a graph, you are going to see the common point, which is called origin. That is like this, this portion, this point. This is common, common in both the cases. This side also, this is O, origin, and in y-axis also, this is y dash, and this is x dash, x O, x dash, y O, y dash, right? So this is y-axis, vertical, this is horizontal, and this is the common point O, right? We call it in short origin. Reference point, some people say, some people call it common point. This is origin basically. Very important section is the scale. What kind of scale you are going to opt in that particular graph? That means your 1 centimeter box is already there. Now you are referring 1 centimeter as what? As how many seconds, how many minutes, how many kilometers, how many meters, etc. So whatever scale you are going to take, you will just write it like this. X-axis, Y. 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter. It is always fixed. You cannot change this. But what you are going to change is the units you are going to use. And the last very important section in the graph is the data, the details, right? So without details, I cannot plot a graph. So very important how a graph looks like. See, dear students, it is in front of you. The graph somewhat looks like this. I have plotted one. I have just highlighted all the things. Now, when you are plotting a graph, make sure you are putting certain highlights and markers over there. Like when you are mentioning x-axis, put an arrow over there because this is a ray. You can extend it. At same thing, you are going to do it y-axis. Arrow, you can extend it this way. Origin O, x dash, y dash. So this complete line, xox, yo, y dash. Put arrows at all the four corners. Then, whatever two comparison units you are taking, two quantities, mention them in the both arms. This is one arm I have taken. This is the other arm I have taken. Time, mention the unit also. Distance, mention the unit also. See, these small little points will fetch you marks, right? Then highlight the points, mark those, plot the points like this. Like if my data in detail is having 2 seconds, 4 seconds, 6 seconds, 8 seconds, a car is moving and 15 meter it is traveling, 30 meter it is traveling, 45 respectively it is moving, then I'm mentioning those points and highlighting it this way. So this is basically this particular graph, and this is the detail about the graph. What is a graph? It is a diagrammatic representation. Then why we are doing it? Easy to see and find the facts. Where exactly we can see the graphs? In matches, in all the any comparative subjects, then the graph is there. When I am scoring good, like the attendance you were having during festivals is different. And other than that, during exam time, your attendance is quite good. We can plot up, make a graph on that point also. Jokes apart, types of graphs, mention line, bar, pie. And very importantly, what exactly are the details to be drawn on a graph? The detail number one, two axes, x and y. Remember, horizontal one is a x-axis and vertical one is a y-axis. Origin, O. The scale should be there. It gives you one marks, and the data is already given in the question paper. So when I have taken all this detail, see, this is the first step, right? Then this is a question detail I have got. This is my question. I have received it. Time in minutes, distance in meter, right? You can easily see a kind of pattern is there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes. 15, 30, 45, 60 and 75. So you can see a pattern. A definite pattern is there. So this uniformity will be seen in the graph also when we will be plotting it. So I have, what I have taken, step 1, plot this perpendicular line. Step 2, write the name of the two units. Mention the units also. And plot these lines, 15, 30, 45, 60. So 45, then mark this point, 60. 75 and so on, 1, 2, 3, and this is how you can move like this. So how you are going to mark that point, like in 1K, 1 minute, it was 15 seconds, right? The respective number was this. So you, in this particular graph, you will move like this. 1 minute, you will go at the back, come to this point 15 and just point this mark. This is your point number 1. If it is 0, 0, then you will mark this point. 2 to 30, so that means you will go this way, 2, back, 30, back. So there they are going to meet it roughly like here. See, I am using a marker right now, but you will always prefer a pointed pencil. So this is how this graph will be plotted, and then take a scale and join all these points. If it is a straight line, that means the DT graph, this is a DT graph, distance time graph, it is a, the DT graph is straight line. It means the car is having uniform motion. But if you find that the graph is coming wavy, it's zigzag, it is not straight, it is curved, then the motion is non-uniform, which we will talk about in our next class. Thank you, everyone.